Test, test. Hello, my name is Tom Marshburn, and I'm an astronaut living and working aboard the International Space Station. This is a spacecraft about the size of a five-bedroom house orbiting 250 miles high, traveling 17,500 miles per hour around the Earth, so fast that we circle the Earth every 90 minutes. Still, we're close enough to be seen from Earth, and we look like a bright star moving across the sky. We get to see spectacular views of the Earth, but we also love to gaze at the beauty of the Moon and our universe. But NASA's getting ready for Artemis I, the first test of our new space launch system, and the Orion spacecraft that will travel thousands of miles beyond the Moon. This mission is helping us get ready to put the first woman and the first person of color on the Moon's surface as we build the knowledge we need to go even further. I'm excited today to read a book that has inspired kids on Earth about our Moon and encouraged them to explore the world around them for 75 years. Goodnight Moon by Margaret Wise Brown. Pictures by Clement Hurd. In the great green room, there was a telephone and a red balloon, and a picture of the cow jumping over the moon, and there were three little bears sitting on chairs, and two little kittens and a pair of mittens, and a little toy house, and a young mouse, and a comb and a brush, and a bowl full of mush, and a quiet old lady who was whispering, "Hush." Goodnight room. Goodnight moon. Goodnight cow jumping over the moon. Goodnight light in the red balloon. Goodnight bears and goodnight chairs. Goodnight kittens and goodnight mittens. Goodnight clocks and goodnight socks. Good night, little house, and good night, mouse. Good night, comb, and good night, brush. Good night, nobody. Good night, mush. And good night to the little old lady whispering, "Hush." Good night, stars. Good night, air. Good night, noises everywhere. Several questions were submitted by students about our experiences here on the space station, which we're happy to answer now. I'm Tom Marshburn, Mark Vande Hei. Both astronauts. And the first question is by Natalie G. from Pennsylvania. What do you do to pass the time when you aren't working on the ISS?
Great question. I like to look out the windows. The views are incredible. I really like to read a lot. And one of my favorite things is to talk to my family back on the Earth. We are very well supported with the ability to make phone calls from up here. Ooh, Tom, this is a good one. This one is from Thea W. from Kansas, who asks, when will we go to the moon again?
Great question. There is the Space Launch System. We're going to be testing it out, and soon we'll be launching that in the Orion spacecraft deep into space. We hope to go to the moon and bring the first crew soon in the next few years to the moon and even land on the moon here in the next decade. Ashlyn B. from Michigan asks, can you see color in space? How would it look if you drew on a piece of paper? Would the colors look the same as on Earth?
Yes, absolutely. We can see colors in space. Our eyes work just the same as long, of course, we're in air up here. And when I look out the window, I'm looking from an air environment out the window into space. But it's very much like when you look up into space and see stars. Of course, you can see mildly different colors because a lot of brightness. But as you can see around us, we've got lots of different colors. Tom and I are dressed in kind of drab colors. Both of us are wearing gray. But we've got lots of flags behind us. You can see colors in there. And when we look out the window, like I mentioned earlier, we can see the colors of the ocean and the deserts and all the shades of different browns and the full moon shining on the terrain is beautiful. And then with city lights at night and the orange of those lights, so many different colors are a joy for us to see up here. So I'm very, very happy that we can see colors in space. Okay, another good question, Tom. Chloe O from Texas, where Tom and I both live, asks, what was the biggest challenge you faced in space so far, and how did you overcome it?
Waiting for your flight is challenging. We do a lot of work to get here. One of the things we have to do is learn another language. Probably learning Russian was one of the biggest challenges I had as a requirement to get here to the space station. But the other challenge is there's so much to do, so much to see up here. It's quite distracting. And so getting any one thing done can be a challenge. All right, Mark. Rocco M from Iowa is asking, if you didn't become an astronaut, what would you have wanted to be?
Part of me wants to join the circus, but I'm kind of joking. I don't think that's not going to happen. I would have loved to have been a teacher. That was a potential career for me. I also was very interested in using my physics background to get involved in production of alternate forms of energy, because we're going to need energy and we've got to find a renewable way to get that. That's inexpensive enough for people to want to use it. So those are very appealing things to me. Also, I have a lot of concern about our environment. So any job that's associated with helping us live more sustainably in the future is something I was interested in. And I might be even more motivated about it now that I've been able to look back on our beautiful planet from space. Caleb W. from Maryland asks, what do stars look like in outer space?
Stars look a bit like they do on Earth. If you went out into a field away from a big city on a cold winter night with no clouds, just bright and brilliant. You can see so many stars countless stars there. However, in space, when we see them, they don't twinkle. There's no atmosphere for the starlight to go through. So they're just direct, steady points of light and quite fascinating and absolutely beautiful. So Mark, Grayson B. from Missouri asks, what is it like to float in space?
If I'm not touching any surfaces, or like Tom is right now, not touching any surfaces, then it's kind of like being in a pool, where for us right now, the only thing that's touching us is our clothes and the air. If you're in a pool, the only thing that's touching you is the water and your swimming suit. So that's the closest analogy I can make. What I would say the best part about it here, though, is the complete freedom of motion. We have a lot of fun doing flips like Tom and I are doing right now. And actually, Tom doesn't know I'm going to ask him to do this yet. And who knows if they'll actually leave this in the video. But you want to try doing that super fast spin? So that does make us very dizzy. When you're spinning like that, the person that's being spun can't tell what's going on because things are going by so fast. So you have to be very trusting because you have no control over where you're going to end up. And then you actually don't get dizzy until the person gets stopped. And then all of a sudden, everything else keeps spinning even though you've stopped moving your body. Something we've been having fun with lately, and everybody's been safe.
Great questions. Thanks. Bye-bye.